Hey everyone. In our last video, we talked about what Lagrange polynomials are and how we can use them to interpolate data. In this video, we're going to go through a first-order Lagrange polynomial interpolation example so that you can see how we solve one of these problems. We are asked to estimate for the output of the following dataset using Lagrange polynomial interpolation. I'm just going to take a second and write out the general formula for any order Lagrange polynomial here. If you have seen our previous video on Lagrange polynomials, we talked about the degree of Lagrange polynomials, and, as we learned, since we have two data points present, we will have two terms in our first order Lagrange polynomial. Our order is our number of data points minus 1. Now, let's talk about how we solve this problem. We will first begin by using the formula above to develop our general first-order Lagrange polynomial equation. Then, we are going to plug in our known discrete data points, simplify our polynomial, and then lastly, once we have the Lagrange polynomial developed, we can plug in the input that we are asked for, and we can finally solve for the output. So, as we stated, our first step is to develop our first-order Lagrange polynomial equation. In brief, we know that we need one term for each data point we need our polynomial to pass through. So, I will just go ahead now and rewrite our general first-order Lagrange polynomial equation. If you are at all confused on how I am developing this first-order equation, check out our Introduction to Lagrange Polynomial video in the description down below. Now that we have written that all out, we have completed our first step in the solution. We must now plug in our data points and simplify, such that the Lagrange polynomial is fit to our specific problem. Since first-order Lagrange polynomials are quite simple, I'm going to go ahead and simplify the solution now. This leaves us with 5x minus 5, which is actually a straight line. Now, if you want to actually do a quick check by plugging our x terms into our Lagrange polynomial, remember that when interpolating our function, it needs to pass through all of the given data points. Therefore, by plugging in our x terms, we need to get our y terms back. I will just go ahead and validate that for you right now. As you can see, we are returned our outputs as expected. Lastly, we just need to plug in the input of 2.2 into our function. This gives us an output of 6, which is the solution to the question that we were initially asked. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of how to solve a first-order Lagrange polynomial example. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.